Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Gala of our Anchor Dome on the campus of Alabama State University. We are 20 minutes away from tip-off. Game one today's swag doubleheader between the Lady Bulldogs of Alabama A&M and your Alabama State Lady Hornets. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, you can find your complimentary copy of today's game day roster and the ticket window in the front entrance of the Gala of our Anchor Dome. You can also find digital roster cards of the men and women's basketball schedules on FamilySportsTV.com.
Thank you.
gentlemen, we are 14 minutes away from tip-off. 14 minutes away is game one. Today's swag football header, your Alabama State Hornets taking on the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M.
Y'all in the house, don't be yelling at me now.
Ladies and gentlemen, Alabama State, as well as the Southwestern Athletic Conference, promote good sportsmanship by our student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, derogatory comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for immediate removal from the site of competition. We are 12 minutes away from tip-off. Game one today's swag doubleheader. Your Alabama State Hornets taking on the Lady Bulldogs of Alabama A&M.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the court, your Alabama State Lady gentlemen, welcome to the court of the visitors, the Bulldogs from Alabama A&M University. tells you we are 3 minutes away from tip-off, your Lady Hornets taking on the Lady Bulldogs of Alabama.
Hello, everybody. Welcome in to Alabama State basketball here at the John Oliver Acadome on the campus of Alabama State University. Today, it's the Hornets, the Lady Hornets, and the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M. Let's find out who will be starting, and we'll also have our national anthem as we get it underway here in a very crucial SWAC game between these two teams that are tied for second place.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to today's Southwestern Athletic Conference women's basketball matchup between the Alabama A&M Lady Bulldogs and your Alabama State Lady Hornets. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please rise. Gentlemen, remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of the with the singing of the country's national anthem by Ms. Siobhan Brown.
Thank you.
Now let's meet the starting football teams. First, the visitors, the Lady Bulldogs of A&M University. At guard, number 0, Darian Bergen. At forward, number 3, Amani Free. At guard, number 4, Tony Grace. At guard, number 23, Taylor Smith. And at center, number 34, Jalen Cody. The head coach of the Lady Bulldogs is Margaret Richards. She is assisted by Larry McNeil, Nyla Johnson, and Katrina Howard.
Basketball will try to take sole possession of second place in the SWAC. They've already clinched a spot in the conference tournament, which will take place March 8th through 11th. But you want to be in second place. Obviously, you want to be the highest seed you can be. And this happens to be the team that they're tied with as far as the standings are concerned. And they had a heck of a game on Monday night, needing three overtimes to beat Bethune-Cookman, a game that they played mostly without Shamiah Ward. But she is back on the court and will play today. She'll be wearing her usual number 21. So we are set to go here. We're expecting a great crowd, one of the bigger rivalries in the SWAC. And we're just about set to get underway. Your officials, Mark Ellen, Demura Pugh, and Chris Markey. There's the tip. Alabama State controls. It is Ayana Emanuel with the basketball. She had a big game. Actually, she's had a big season, averaging 17 points a game. That is Jayla Crawford also starting. And Ward has her first point, first two of the game for anybody. She came in, despite being injured, in the third overtime and came and helped this team pick up the victory. I don't think, and I'm just giving my opinion, I'm not sure they would have won the basketball game had she not come in. She could barely walk, and she came in and played an incredible game to help ASU get the very important victory over Bethune-Cookman. Emmanuel tries to drive cutoff. Skip pass to Crawford. She'll drive to the lane. Lob pass. Ward can't do anything with it. Kicks it back out. There's a three. It's short. And the ball will be tipped in the air, and we're going to get a foul on, I believe, Emmanuel. That is the first foul on her. First foul of the quarter against Alabama State. ASU with a 14-12 record, 11-4 in conference play. These two teams almost identical as far as the record is concerned. The Bulldogs come in 13-12 and 11-4 overall. Very big rivalry to say the least. They played back on January 16th, but they played in Mobile. A game won by A&M. In fact, the Bulldogs swept the two games. Women winning 60-46, one of the worst shooting nights that the Lady Hornets have had all year, shot just 27%. They'll have to improve on that if they want to win today. Dump pass inside goes to Free. She is their leading scorer, and she took steps. That's two times now. Alabama A&M has taken extra steps. Still just a 2-0 lead. We're early. Bulldogs set up at a 2-3 zone. In the corner, that is Steele. And they work it around. They bring Ward way out front. Three-pointer is no good by Emmanuel. Rebound, Alabama A&M. Burgeon the other way. Leaves it outside the arc. Skips a pass to Free. He'll try the three, and it's good. Amani Free, excuse me, had coming into this game, 42 three-pointers. You can add one to that number. And an early lead for the Bulldogs, 3-2. Emmanuel in the corner. Again, working against the zone. There's a dump pass to Ward. What do we got? They may have called 3 seconds. And I think they did. So the turnover gives it back to the Bulldogs. Simmons into the ball game for Alabama A&M, a sophomore out of Osawatomie, Kansas. I didn't know if I'd have to say that town today or not. 3-2 early. Driving to the lane is Smith. Throws it, has to be chased down though. There's a three up and good. Wow. Free with another three. And I don't mean to be whimsical when I say that. 6-2. Harris inside to Emmanuel for a bucket. That's the lead to 2. Driving in, and a little scoop shot is blocked, but they're going to get a foul on somebody. Possibly Harris. Well, they call it on Emmanuel, and that is her second. She quickly picks up 2 fouls. And I'm guessing that they're going to take her out with 6:52 left in the first quarter. Maya Simmons shooting 2, a 68% shooter for the Bulldogs. Rita Freeman Jackson is going to leave her out there, apparently. Bulldogs with the mere free throws. It's in the game for the Lady Hornets, number 4. And then, as I say that, they bring in Nakia Sanders for Emmanuel. 7-4 our score. Still the zone in play for Alabama A&M. Steele tries to drive, working right, spinning, kicks it out front. That's Sanders. Shot is good. First 2 for Nakia Sanders. She only averaged 2.5. 1-point lead for A&M. Burgeon gets a pick. But gets picked up by Ward. Underneath, shot is no good by Cody. Good defense by Harris. 5:48 left. May be a big game for the guards if they stay in the, that could be a walk. You know. Didn't quite get it out of my mouth before they called it Crawford guilty. This is one thing as Brazil Watkins comes into the game. But I got to give credit to the Lady Hornets in their last game against Bethune-Cookman. I don't have the score sheet in front of me, but they probably played 11 players in that game, and it seems like every single one of them contributed in some way. That's important. The deeper you get into the season, is a nice lob pass, foul on Ward in the bucket. First foul on Ward. That was a great lob pass. Chanel Mitchell will go to the line to shoot the one shot for a three-point play. Going back to what I was saying, this team needed everybody to contribute. They were behind big at 1.7 points late and figured out a way to come out of it with a win. They got great work inside with Harris. Danielle Bolton played several minutes. Ryan Tillis, all of them. And then Ward came in to make it official. There's a floater. Got it. And the foul. Still with her first two. Mitchell gets the foul. First one on A&M in the game. Asia Harris will return, replacing Ward. They're wearing matching leg straps. I'm not sure what you would call that, to be honest. Obviously to help circulation. 1 point game again. Imagine McCallop in the game for A&M. There's a shot blocked, out of bounds. They'll say A&M touched it last. Chanel Mitchell wanted a foul. She's not going to get it. We played half of this first period, 10-9. A&M on top. We'll be back.
Into the game for the Hornets, number 13, Brazil Watkins. After the timeout, position Hornets.
.447 to go here early, first quarter. 10-9, Alabama A&M, but the Hornets have the basketball trying to take the lead. Shot is up and short. Looks like we're going to get a rebounding foul on Alabama State. That may go on Watkins, who just entered the game before. I was going to try to say before that missed shot. Both teams shooting 60% or better in the first quarter. Now not quite so good for Alabama State. A&M with a lay into the basketball. Inside, and what do we got? Looks like a reach-in foul on Alabama State. Amaya Simmons got position underneath, and she'll go back to the line to shoot a pair. That foul was called on Steele. First foul on her. And five team fouls now on Alabama State. First free throw hits the front of the rim, no good. Simmons, a sophomore, averaging 10 points a game for Coach Margaret Richards in her fifth year at Alabama A&M. She makes one of two. 2-point game, A&M on top. That's Kristen Jackson in the game. Watkins has it, gets a pick. Leaves it for Jackson. Around the horn they go, and that one's thrown away. Sanders tried to get it back to Jackson, but she wasn't looking. That's Grace with a basketball. That one's stolen. Sanders stepping into the passing lane. Shot is good. Sanders has a bucket, and then she gets a steal. From the corner, three, no good. Rebound. A couple of ASU players fighting for the basketball, and it's knocked out of bounds by the Bulldogs. Sanders has been all over the court so far in this first period. She got a couple of steals, a couple of buckets. Game is tied at 11. Now she's got it in the corner. Now she'll launch a three. Got it! Right now, it's the Dakaya Sanders show. She's got seven. ASU with a three-point advantage. That's Smith with a basketball. Grace driving, gets a nice pick. Missed the shot, late whistle. It was a foul. I don't know what they were waiting on. Ryan Tillis is in the game, picks up the foul. It's her first. 16 fouls now on ASU here in this first period. And back to the line goes an A&M player. This time it's Tony Grace, who was the leading scorer on this team, but she only has 12 points per game. They spread the wealth. She missed the first free throw. She is an 82% shooter at the line. And she's good on one of two. Darian Burgeon back in the game for the Bulldogs. That 2-point lead for Alabama State. There's a shot, another three that's too strong. Rebound Alabama A&M. Driving, Smith kicks it out. There's a three, yeah. Wow, Grace. You can see why she leads the team in scoring. She has four quick points. And the lead back to A&M. There's one from the top of the key, inside the arc, putback is good. Kristen Jackson has her first two of the game. That's what her average is. 16 to 15. Smith working on Sanders. Now Simmons leaves it for Cody, who'll drive in inside, miss the shot. We've got a whistle before the putback. They're going to call it on the first shot.
First personal. Two shots.
And they'll get Kristen Jackson for the foul. First foul on Kristen. And more free throws for Alabama A&M. And as long as they're making one out of two, we're okay with that. And that's basically what's been done so far. Cody, a 57% shooter. And she missed them both. Sanders quickly the other way. Jackson on the extension of the elbow. Dump pass inside, Ward's back in, spinning to her left, missed the shot, but she drew the foul. I think they'll get Cody. Jayla Cody's first foul. Two shots coming for Shamiah Ward, who shoots 65% at the line.
First basket is good.
One more coming. Hope everybody's having a great Saturday afternoon. Enjoying some basketball here at the Dunn Oliver Aquadome. Driving quickly is Smith. Circles back out and runs right into a double team. That's Alabama State basketball. Nice defense. I don't know what she was thinking, but we don't mind it. Turnover gives it back to Alabama State. Five turnovers now against the Bulldogs. 1 minute to go here in the first quarter. Crawford in the corner. Jackson launches a three. Yes! Kristen Jackson with three to give her five for the game. That is her fifth three-pointer of the year. Grace to Cody. Now Bergen. 30 seconds on the clock. 12 on the shot. Bergen driving. Can't get the shot to fall. Rebound Alabama State. Jackson rips it down. Here comes Sanders. 5-point lead for the Hornets. Tillis dumps one inside. Nearly too high. And another high pass goes to Crawford. Back to Ward, and the shot is made. And I'll have to admit, as 3 seconds ticking off the clock, long three, no. And that's how it'll end, 22-15. I was saying the net was wrapped around the rim, and it kind of caught me off guard. I apologize. 22-15. After a quarter of play, we got plenty more coming up on the Hornet Sports Network.
department. Items being raffled off are a mini grill tailgate basket, outdoor game night, and a restaurant gift card. The Sports Medicine Student Aid Program consists of undergraduate students and experience in the field of athletic training. Visit them on the concourse today to purchase your ticket. Winners will be announced at halftime of the women's and men's game. Must be present to win all sales final.
One quarter in the books here at the Acadome. A good finish by ASU in that first quarter to lead at 22-15. It is A&M basketball. If we start, they have trouble getting it in as the Hornets switch defenders on the inbounds pass, and somehow, some way, A&M comes up with it. Inside shot is no good. We're going to get a late whistle again. This is going on Sanders. There was one problem for ASU in that first quarter. It was foul trouble. They had seven fouls, including two called on Ayanna Emanuel very early. She got them within the first 3 minutes of the game. So they've had eight fouls now called on them here in this first period. Gallup makes both free throws. 6-point game. Crawford has to pull it out, goes to Steele. Sanders had a good first quarter. She had 7 points. There's a three, almost from 1 foot, no good. Rebound, Alabama A&M. Crawford just kind of last second decided to shoot that one. Cody dumps one inside, throws it away, but somehow it ends up with McCollum, who'll skip one in the corner. Burgeon shot, no. Rebound, ASU. That's Crawford. Sanders near court. She'll launch another three. She's hot. Why not? Double figures for Nakia Sanders. We still got 8.5 minutes left in the second quarter. Harris is all over free, and that's got to be a travel. It is. It back to the Hornets. Leading it by nine, their biggest lead so far. We will have Senior Day festivities, but both the women's and the men's team will be celebrated as part of the men's game, which will be coming up as soon as this one's over. They will recognize the men's seniors before the men's game, and then the women's game, that'll be an illegal screen. And that goes on Harris. The women's senior day will take place at halftime. Of course, we'll have them here. You can watch those on the Hornet Sports Network. 8:14 left, first half. Taylor Smith brings it across for the Bulldogs. Both teams tied for second place in the league, 11-4. Shot off the glass, no. Rebound, State. Here comes Sanders. Still driving. She's got a lane. Instead, tries to kick it out, and it is off of an A&M player out of bounds. Tillis to Sanders. It's like the Bulldogs have I believe they've gone to a man-to-man. Nice inside pass, and then a foul call. They'll get it on Cody. And that's her second. We'll see Emmanuel. Despite two fouls, she's going to come back in. Ward is at the line to shoot a pair. She's made one out of two so far today. Junior out of Memphis, Whitehaven High School. That one rims out.
One shot.
Second shot is good.
Hornets split to Peter free throws.
Ten-point lead for the Hornets. Smith, cross-court pass. Inside it goes. Shot is no good. Rebound, Tillis. She has really come on as the freshman from Atlanta. Getting more and more minutes in each game. Now she's setting a pick for Steele. Around the horn, into the corner. The shot is no good. There's Tillis fighting for the rebound. Crawford back to Ward to Tillis. Why not? That was all hers that time. Her first bucket. She got the steal, she got the rebound, and she got the points. Well-rounded trip for the Hornets. Driving is Simmons. No good. Rebound ASU. Crawford the other way. Left it short. Rebound A&M. McCallop, and what do we got? A timeout taken by the Bulldogs. 6:26 to play in the half. And we got a timeout on the floor. We'll take it with them. Lady Hornets lead it by 12. We'll be back.
Don't forget to stick around for game two of this afternoon's double dinner at your Hornets St. Louis Alabama Bulldogs. 30 minutes after the conclusion of this game. After timeout, possession Bulldogs.
Well, at least so far, the ASU defense has come to play in this one. They have held Alabama A&M without a field goal since the 2:15 mark of the first quarter. We're 6:26 right now in the second. I'll let you do the math, but it's been a while. They have made a couple of free throws. And we got a whistle away from the basketball, make it a hold on somebody. It'll go on Jackson. I beg your pardon. Well, it is on Jackson, I beg your pardon. Second foul on Kristen. That's three fouls now on the Hornets. Going back, their last points from the field. And as I say that, they get it inside. One shot is blocked. Ward blocked another. Third try, no good. Rebound battle for, and we're going to get it going the other way. Over the back goes Mitchell to pick up her second foul. A couple of blocks for Ward on that trip. It'll go back to the Hornets, leading it by 12. 6:11 to go, first half. Another empty trip for Alabama A&M. Still inside. Nice pass to Ward. Emmanuel with the assist. And we're under 6 minutes and a 14-point advantage for Alabama State. Smith driving, leaves it on the baseline. Shot is missed. Another missed shot. ASU the other way. Jackson, she's been hot. Not that time. Rebound, though, for Crawford. Right-handed shot missed. Ball loose, picked up by A&M. Simmons by over to McCallop. Quick pass underneath, and that'll be a foul on Tillis. Second foul on her. Well, I'll say this, she didn't give up the easy one. Should be four team fouls against Alabama State. Donna Frazier at the line, a freshman from Lenners, Ohio. Doesn't play a lot. He only averages a point and a half a game. She made that free throw, 55% normally at the line. And that one's no good. Harris had it, lost it. Collects it and goes to Tillis. Now it goes over to Sanders. 5 minutes to go in the half. Jackson thought about a tray, instead kicks it back to Sanders. They're playing cat and mouse with the A&M defense. Six on the shot clock. Steele tries to dump it inside, ends up with Harris, missed the shot. Rebound though, collected by Crawford to put it in. First two of the day for Crawford. Lead is 15. Things going right for the Hornets so far in this first half. Spin move and a shot by Frey, and they finally break the string of going without a field goal. First one since the 2:15 mark of the first quarter, and it comes almost a quarter later. Sanders to Jackson. Now has it on the far side. Crawford, pull up, hit as she goes up. That'll be on Bergen. That's her first. And that should be free throws.
Official review.
I have no idea what they're going to check here, but they're going to check something. Or do we have another timeout? I believe they're going to look at the monitor. They do get the foul on Burgess.
Going to look for a possible unobserved potential foul on that play down there.
I don't know if you could hear that, but a possible unabated. Is that a win or a loss? You're showing me softball, Fred Sinkton. They pick up softball. We've got a big tournament this weekend. And ASU just picked up a big win over South Carolina State, 6-3. And I believe that's their third win. Is that right? Third win of this tournament. So they got things going well over there. Also, the baseball team is down in New Orleans last night. You might have seen it. They were on the MLB Network. Knocked off Grambling. They needed extra innings, but they won big, 10-4. And they're playing again today against Southern. Now, these are not conference games. So congratulations to all our teams. Spring has sprung. And if you don't believe me, I'm sniffling from all the pollen. I don't think I've ever had to wash my car in February because of pollen, but I have to right now. Two shots coming up for Crawford. They were checking for a possible personal foul technical on the other end. Apparently there was not one. So we continue on. Second shot for Crawford. And she's perfect on both. Make it a 15-point lead. Shot off the glass, short. Out of bounds off of Alabama State. I can't remember the last time ASU had a double-digit lead in the first half. It's been a while, at least here. Seems like every game has been nip and tuck. So far today, not so much. Well, we got plenty of time left. Let's hope it stays that way. There's a nice bounce pass as Gray spins into the lane. Shot off the glass, no. Gets her on rebound. And they'll restart with Free out front. McCallop near midcourt. Grace. Free. And they didn't get it off before the shot clock expired. Shot clock violation.
Substitution into the game for the Hornets, number 13.
Turnover number 8 against the Lady Bulldogs. Harris sits down in favor of Brazil Watkins, who's in the game for the first time. The freshman out of Battle Creek, Michigan. Three in the air. Yep, it's good for Crawford. And they are spreading the wealth today. Biggest lead for ASU. 37-19. There's a nice shot and a made shot on the other end. Burgeon with her first two. 2.5 to play. Crawford another three. Missed it this time, though. Out of bounds. It'll go back to A&M. Can't make them all. But right now, Alabama State's making a lot of them. They're shooting 70% from the field. Incredible shooting performance here in the first half by the Hornets. Burgeon in the corner, spinning, cut off. Nice defense by Jackson, and I believe Ward came over to block it, and then the loose ball off the hands of A&M, it'll go back to Alabama State. About four blocks for Ward today. We're still in the first half. Lob pass. Missed the shot. Gets it back. Puts it up. It's going to roll in. Third field goal for Ward. She has a couple of free throws to go with it for 8 points. A minute 45 to play in the half. The lead is 18 for ASU. Missed shot on the Euro step. Somebody needs to help Cody. Instead, they get it out and a three made by Simmons. Believe it or not, her first field goal of the game. Seems like she had a couple already. 15-point lead for the Hornets. Skip pass all the way to Steele. Or excuse me, that is a shot no good by Watkins, but she gets it back. Right now, that's the big part of this game. They are getting the offensive boards. They've got 7 so far. Crawford driving, shot, no. Ward tips it out. Here comes Watkins, yes. Watkins with a kiss off the glass, the lead back to 17. Burgeon's top of the key. McCallop working on Steele. Has to come out, goes to her center who's standing at the free throw line, and they're gonna get a foul on Warren. Thought she got all ball, but apparently not. That is her second. 30 seconds to go. They will quickly get Danielle Bolton into the game for Ward to protect her from getting that third foul. And Jayla Cody, who missed both tries at the line her first trip, will try two more. And she's now 0 for 3. She averages about 5 a game, and she finally makes one. Shot clock and game clock are almost identical. 22 on, 21 on both. They can hold it if they want. Sanders. Out of steal. That's Crawford. Pulling up with 7 seconds to go and can't get the roll. Rebound A&M. 3 seconds. 2-1. Did they get it off? It doesn't matter. It didn't go in. And Alabama State will take a 16-point advantage into the locker room here at halftime. Great shooting in that first half. They do finish right around 50%, but they also make 4 of 12 threes, and they've gotten, once again, great contribution from their bench with several players, including Ryan Tillis, Nikaya Sanders, Samantha Steele, all coming. Actually, she was the starter, but Kristen Jackson was not. And Brazil Watkins also with a bucket. So a good first half for the bench, good first half for the Hornets as they lead it 41-25 at the break. We will be back to get you started in the second half in just a few minutes. Stay tuned on the Hornets Sports Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome to the court the Southmont Middle School Lady Rockets. The Southmont Middle School Lady Rockets are led by coach Chris McDermott. They finished the season a perfect 20-0. Southmont Middle won the regular season championship and would go on to defeat McKee Middle School in the Montgomery Public School Championship game 21-16 to win the tournament championship. Congratulations to the Southmont Middle School Lady Rockets and Coach Thurman. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a round of applause. They are scholars and champions. Hornet Nation, welcome to the floor, our 2023 Indoor Track and Field Championship team. Coach B has won an Top of the second half, your score, your team, Hornets 41, the Lady Bulldogs of Alabama A&M 25.
We're just about ready for the start of the second half. A good first half for Alabama State, 41-25. The Lady Hornets with a lead over Alabama A&M. A couple of numbers, and again, I want to go back to that stretch in which Alabama State held A&M without a field goal between the 2:15 mark of the first quarter and about the 4:50 mark of the second quarter. It's about 8 minutes, and that is when ASU built this lead. They have maintained it pretty much the entire first half. They got 10 points from Dekiah Sanders off the bench. Shamiah Ward also had 10 points. In fact, bench scoring was pretty incredible for ASU in that first half. 19 bench points for the Lady Hornets. And we're underway. ASU with the basketball. They did that without Ayanna Emanuel, basically. She did not play much of that first half due to foul trouble. First shot by Ward is blocked. A&M the other way. Smith pulls it back. Both teams back with their original starting five. Has a little bit of a push off, but it's not going to be called. Taylor, scoreless in the first half, gets her first bucket. And it's 41-27. Don't relax, girls. Keep the pressure on. Emanuel. Outside it goes to Crawford. Now to Ward at the foul line. Tries to dump it inside to Harris. She lost it. Back to Ward. He'll try the shot from 15 feet. No good. Rebound. Like a ping pong ball, ends up in the hands of Harris, who put it in. She was held scoreless in the first half. She has her first two. Back to a 16-point lead. Grace driving, offensive foul.
Offensive foul.
That is the first on her, first on the team in the third quarter. They'll give it back to Alabama State. Again, doubleheader as always here. The men will follow this one. And if you missed the beginning of the broadcast, we have second place. That's what they're playing for today between these two. First place is pretty much done. Jackson State has clinched that, all but clinched it. Emmanuel can't shake loose. Crawford having trouble. 4 seconds on the shot clock. Crawford pull up, shot good. Crawford has 9 points. She had 7 in the first. 8 minutes to go, third quarter. There's a three, a long one. Side rim no good. Out of bounds. Back to ASU.
Substitution into the game for the Bulldogs, number 11, Elijah Simmons. Possession points.
So the Hornets will bring it the other way, leading it by the score 45-27, an 18-point advantage. That is their, matches their largest lead of the game. Steele nearly threw it away off of A&M, though, as the ball is knocked out of bounds by Bergen. Pair of zeros guarding each other right now. Bergen wearing 0, Emmanuel wearing 0. And it is Emmanuel with the basketball. Trying to drive on Bergen. She's got good defense on, and that's going to cause a turnover. Emmanuel tried to drive to her left. Bergen cut her off, tried to drive to her right, cut her off there, and then she traveled. Taylor Smith. Outside it goes to Simmons. Simmons has not been able to break free. She is a pretty good three-point shooter for Alabama A&M. Spinning is Smith. No good on the shot. Rebound Harris. I told you that ASU shot 27% the first time these two teams met back in January. They're doing a lot better than that today, almost 50%. Ward kicks it in the corner. Emmanuel pull up inside the arc, no good, rebound A&M. Smith in a hurry, 1-on-3 and lost it out of bounds.
Out of bounds on the play.
I don't know where she had planned to go with that. It ended up the abyss as she lost it out of bounds. Here comes Ryan Tillis, who had a good first half. She only scored 2 points, but she was tough on the boards, tough on defense. Cody is out, replaced by LaCambria Shakespeare. No relation. Crawford top of the key. Steele. And there's a steal by Free. Seven turnovers by Alabama State. Simmons has it at the foul line. Turns around and missed the shot. Left it long. Rebound Crawford. Crawford racing the other way. Looking inside. They want to get it to Jackson, make it Tillis, excuse me. Ward is out of the game right now. Crawford from the baseline, no good. And the Bulldogs go the other way. What do we got? We got a foul on somebody. We got to call a foul on Crawford.
Foul on Chandler, number 3, Chandler Crawford.
I don't know what happened there. Crawford was running down court. She may have pushed somebody. I'm assuming that's what she did. So she picks up her first foul. Kristen Jackson in the game, as is Dekaya Sanders, who had a team-high 10 in that first half, along with Ward. They dump it inside to Free, who will turn around and knock it home. And did we get a foul? We got one, but who's it on? They call it on Tillis. That was a flop, and they get awarded for it. That's all that was. Free will go to the line to try to make it a three-point play. Tillis had turned around for the rebound. And I call a foul on him.
Substitution into the game for the Hornets, number three, Chandler Crawford.
That's the lead to 15. Sanders will bring it across for Alabama State. Dump pass to Harris. Spinning, reversing, gets knocked to the ground, and they'll call a foul. Should be on Shakespeare.
First personal, second team foul. Cortesia Harris at the line is shooting two.
I thought about
two shots.
Brushing up on my Shakespeare before the game, but I decided not to. That'd be too obvious. Harris misses the first free throw. Harris has 2 points in the game, which is well below her average. I talked to her the other night after the game. You'll notice she's got a black headband on. She misses the second. She's got red-colored hair. The game before that, she had a white headband on. I said, so did you change because you looked like you had on a Santa Claus hat? And she laughed, and she knocks that one out of bounds. She said, no, it didn't have the logo on it. The team logo, well, not the team logo, but the shoe logo, which is Adidas. But she got a kick out of my question. Spinning and shooting and missing is Shakespeare. Rebound Alabama State. By the way, Shakespeare, 6'4", out of Duluth, Georgia. Sanders waiting for the offense to get set. They'll run the wheel. 9 on the shot clock. Jackson. Needs to do something with it. Gives it off to Crawford. He'll drive. Got up. No, she didn't. I thought she might have got away with the travel, but they called it. And we got a timeout on the floor. It is a media timeout. 15-point lead for Alabama State over Alabama A&M. We'll be back. .426 left to play in the third quarter. Alabama A&M has whittled a little bit off of the ASU lead. And they have the basketball as we get started again. Burgeon against Jackson. Make it Watkins, I beg your pardon. Now to McCallop, driving right side. Hit going up, doesn't make the shot. They'll call a foul on Sanders. It's her second. Been a good game, though, for the sophomore out of Ramsey High School in Birmingham. She's got 10 points, all of those coming in the first half. She only averages about 2.5 a game. Meanwhile, at the line is McCallop. And she missed the first free throw, an 81% shooter. Missed them both. Ward rebounds, hands off to Sanders. She's racing, nothing but purple jerseys downfield. She'll pull it out. And Emma's been in the man-to-man basically since they lost the lead. In the corner, Emmanuel, three, rebound on the missed shot by Bergen. And they throw it away, trying to hit Simmons running down court. Give it back to ASU.
Y'all got
to
score, y'all got to score.
3.5 to play, we're in the third quarter. They've led by as many as 18 as Alabama State. Inside Ward, quick move to the hole, good. Quick spinning move to her right. 17-point lead again. The other way, offensive foul, I believe, yes. And it was Watkins who took the foul. They've done that a lot today. ASU just seems to be a step quicker than A&M today. Some days you have them like that. They can add to their lead here. Emmanuel sits down. And we'll get a substitution for the Bulldogs. Jayla Cody back in the game. And here comes Bekiah Sanders. Nice pass inside, but Ward can't make the shot. Oh, what a heck of a pass. Rebound, A&M. Simmons driving, leaves it outside for Grace. She nearly threw it away. Smith collects with 17 on the shot clock. Gets a pick. They try to roll Cody, but she's not open. Now they do get it to her. Ward's all over. Bounce pass. Nice one to Simmons, but no good on the shot. But the tip out goes back to A&M. Three is in the air by Smith. No. Rebound again. Collected by A&M. Cody with it. This will be their third crack at it on this trip, unless they don't get off a shot. 10 on the shot clock. Cody at the foul line. No good again. Another shot put back and one. Free. Got another rebound. This time she found it to go in the hole, and she picked up a foul on Alabama State. Three team fouls. Crawford was guilty of that foul. Missed the shot. Rebound, Alabama State. 15-point lead. Emmanuel, top of the key. Jackson has it. Make it Watkins. Ward pulling up, goes inside, shot too strong, rebound loose, and a foul underneath. It's going to go on A&M. Call a push on Tony Grace. Second foul on her. Inbound pass coming from the baseline. They get it to Emmanuel. Pump and a shot, and it's good. She's been a bit quiet today on the scoring end, 4 points. But something tells me she'll be in the middle of it before it's all over. 17-point lead. Look at that defense by Sanders. Staring into the eye of a tiger. Nice pick. Shot is no good. Ward may have partially blocked it, though. It ends up with Grace. She'll try the shot off the glass. That time she got popped on the head. And I think they're going to get it on Harris. Well, Deja picks up her second foul. Make it her third, I beg your pardon. She'll have to leave. She'll be replaced by Ryan Tillis.
Two shots
for the grad student from Fishers, Indiana, Tony Grace. Loose ball comes down to Sanders. They'll try to trap her in backcourt. Forget that. Driving Emmanuel, count it. And nope, they're going to call offensive foul. And that's her third. I kept waiting to see if somebody was in the circle, and apparently they weren't. So wipe out the bucket and give it back to Alabama A&M. Grace for A&M out front. Now to Smith. Lead is down to 14. Under a minute to play here in this third quarter. Bergen on Tillis. And they'll call a foul on Tillis. And that's four on her, if I'm not mistaken. I believe I'm right. We'll verify in a minute. Meanwhile, Bergen at the line to shoot a pair. Be about as close as A&M has been in a while. That's good. Bergen had a field goal in the first half. She's got that first free throw, now got a second try. And that one rims out. Issue the other way. 24 seconds to go. No shot clock. Got to get a good shot here to end the quarter, and we've got a foul underneath. They're going to get a hold. I believe that's going on Chanel Mitchell. So that'll put Shamiah Ward at the line. Emmanuel leads. Steele will take her place, and Ward with a chance to knock down a pair of free throws. She has been there a couple of times today. She's 2 for 4.
First basket is good.
And double figures with 13 points. She missed the second. 15 seconds to go. Bergen racing in the corner. Smith launches, missed the shot, rebound out of bounds, touch pass by A&M. 4 seconds on the clock. Just don't turn it over in backcourt. And that'll run out the clock. Good move by Steele. And not try anything drastic, you don't need it. You got a 16-point lead. As we head to the fourth quarter, more coming up on the Hornet Sports Network. Stay tuned.
Top of the fourth quarter, possession Bulldogs.
Well, hey, when the announcer scored it, I said, oh, God.
All right, another quarter to go here at the Acadome. A 16-point advantage for Alabama State as we start this fourth period. A little bit of foul trouble for the Hornets. A couple of players with three fouls. We've got one, Ryan Tillis with four. As A&M will inbound to start. They give it to Grace, who'll drive inside. We get a blocking foul. That's going to be no shot.
Blocking foul.
It'll be on the floor. They're going to get Crawford for the bucket. Excuse me, for the foul. That's her third. No free throws. It'll be an inbound at the baseline. It is three on Crawford. Getting a little perspiration off the floor. Bounce pass underneath. They try to get it to Free. Instead, she has to kick it out to a double team. Persian good on the floater. 5 points for her in the game. It's a 14-point ASU lead. Sanders driving left. Behind the back, leaves it for Crawford. Now Emmanuel has it, thought about a three. They're guarded closely by Grace, now into the lane. Underhand, a shot no good. Grace with the rebound, she's going the other way. Down court, Smith, layup is good. Frieda Freeman Jackson wants a timeout. She has not liked the way that this quarter has started. And so she takes it with barely a minute gone by here in this fourth period, and it's a 12-point lead now for ASU. We'll take a break and be back. Jackson calling this timeout, not happy with the way the fourth quarter started as the Bulldogs have cut 6 points off that lead, now 50 to 38. And they're putting pressure in backcourt. 3 seconds on the clock, they finally get it across. Need a bucket here, they dump it inside. Ward strong to the hole and picks up the foul. They'll get Mitchell with her, I believe, her fourth. And that is the case. Mitchell has four fouls. She will leave. Replaced by Cody. Ward shooting a pair.
First basket is good.
First shot is good.
One shot.
She made them both. That gives her 15 points for the game. Inside it goes to Grace, and she just lost it. Ward takes it over to Sanders, and they'll set up shop. Emmanuel inside the foul line. Circle. They'll get it to Ward again. What do we got? An foul inside. The entry pass to Ward. They'll get Jayla Cody. That is her third.
Second team foul. Possession points.
Well, let me back up. They say that's just her second. Inside Emmanuel. Yes.
2 point basket.
6 points for her. And the lead right back to 16. Bergen pulling up inside the arc and makes the shot. That was a two. 14-point lead now for ASU. She averages 4.5 a game. She's got 7 today. Sanders stopping at the foul line. Nice pass to Ward. Spinning shot, good. Sanders set it up with a nice pass. Ward brings it home. 56-40. High arching shots and air ball. But it comes down to A&M. Missed the putback. ASU's got it. Sanders does not have the numbers. 1-on-3. She'll slow it up. Try again to go inside. This time it's knocked away. Cody stepped in front of the pass. 6:48 and counting left in this one. And I believe Coach Margaret Richards wants a timeout. And I believe this will be a 30-second timeout. 6:44 to go. 16-point lead for Alabama State. Again, the men's game coming up after this one. Of course, against the A&M Bulldogs. The Hornets need some help. They are right now outside looking in as far as the SWAC tournament is concerned. They basically have to win out, and that's going to be tough to do. This is the last home game of the year. They'll go to Southern and then to Grambling to finish out the season. Now, they have a win over Southern. They beat them here a few weeks ago. But then, even if they win those three games, they're going to need some help. Meanwhile, the ladies are in. They will hopefully play as the number 2 seed. They win today, they will have the, at least for the moment, the lead over Alabama A&M, which is tied with Alabama State for number 2. But they, as well as the men, will have to go to Grambling and to Southern. That's actually who Alabama A&M has left to play as well. So they'll basically just flip-flop the game. And the games will be this week, this next week on Thursday and Saturday. There are plenty of other games going on as far as the SWAC is concerned. Got to give you a quick rundown of some scores. I'll work on that here, and we'll give them to you here in a second. We do not have a final yet among the women's games.
Position Bulldogs.
Bulldogs have the basketball. 6:40 and counting left to play in this one. The lead is 16 for ASU. Simmons drive to the baseline. Double team. Back out front. Grace, three. No. And a good block out by Crawford. See if ASU will slow the pace a bit. Emmanuel thought about a tray, instead kicks it over to Sanders. 10 on the shot clock. There's a shot, no good. Rebound, A&M. Simmons will take it herself. Tries to reverse, instead Free has it and puts it up off the glass, and we have a foul. We do.
Foul on the shot.
So Free with a bucket. This will be the third time she's had a chance for a three-point play in this half. Crawford will leave in favor of Samaya Steele. She makes it for a three-point play. She has 16 points. Dump pass out of reach. They'll say A&M touched it last. We might have a discussion. Nope, they're going to change their mind and give it back to A&M. So the turnover's starting to mount a little bit against Alabama State. They've also hit a bit of a lull in the scoring. Still have the lead at 13. Dump pass to the foul line it goes. The shot rims out and then back in for Cody. It was her first field goal of the game. They get a little shanky in here now. 11-point lead for ASU. Steele. Now to Sanders. Get it to Emmanuel, top of the key. 8 on the shot clock. Steele driving, outside kick. Sanders from three land, too long. Rebound loose, picked up by A&M. Grace driving. Nobody picked her up. She lays it in without any trouble. And a timeout call by Alabama State. It's been a while since A&M has been behind by single digits, but that's where they are right now. A 56-47 lead for the homestanding Lady Hornets. We got more on the way here at the Acadome. Stay tuned. With the basketball. Now their lead just 9 points with 4.5 minutes to play. They've hit a drought here of late. Have not scored but a bucket in this fourth period. They need one here. Stop the bleeding. They'll try Emmanuel in the corner. She answers. Big three for Ayanna Emmanuel. Grace the other way. Nobody picks her up, but she missed the shot. The rebound is knocked out of bounds. Touch left, I believe, by Emmanuel. That's about twice now that Tony Grace has gotten loose for an easy bucket. She just missed that one. Smith dumps one inside. She gets a return pass out near the timeline. 10 on the shot. Tried to set up for a three-pointer. Instead, she finds Cody underneath, and Cody is fouled by Watkins. Watkins didn't set her feet. First foul on Brazil. And I believe that's three on the Hornets in this quarter. So with under 4 minutes to play, De La Cote will shoot a pair.
First basket is good.
She's made one out of four before that one. She's now 2 for 5.
Lady Bulldogs convert both free throws.
10-point lead for ASU. Steal. And they'll work clock. Tillis thought about a dump pass. Instead, back out it goes to Steele. 9 on the shot. Driving is Steele, and she got tripped.
Foul.
It'll be on Grace.
Charge for the Bulldogs.
I've got her with three fouls.
Position Hornets.
So a new shot clock. They're looking to Ward inside. She's not open. Tillis thought about a shot. Instead, gives it outside to Steele. 6 on the shot. There's a shot in the air. No good. Rebound A&M. And they throw it away.
Out of bounds on the play. Position Hornets. Substitution into the game for the Bulldogs. Number 11, Amaya Simmons. Into the game for the Hornets. Number 3, Jayla Crawford. Position Hornets.
Inbounds pass coming on the sideline. New 30-second shot clock with 3:08 to go. Inside, and we got a whistle. I think that's going to send Crawford to the line to shoot a couple.
Foul charge for the Lady Bulldogs, number 3, Amani Free. 2 shots. Substitution into the game for the
Hornets. Guilty of her first foul.
Cortesia Harris. Jayla Crawford at the line, shooting 2. One shot.
Crawford had made her first two, but that one no good. And that one is good. Free throw's got to be pretty big here late. Under 3 minutes. Inside, shot is good. Smith with her third bucket of the day. Very quick foul called on A&M. It's on Taylor Smith. First foul on her, and that should send Sanders to the line.
Substitution into the game for the Hornets. Number 21, Shamaria Ward.
First free throws of the day for Dekaya.
Into the game for the Hornets, number 2, Brian Tillis.
Tillis is in.
2 shots.
Replacing Harris. Again, free throws are going to be important the rest of the way out. Sanders good on the first.
1 shot.
11 points for Dekaya Sanders. 10 of those coming in the first half. But she missed the second. Rebound, Emmanuel. Reverse layup is good. Oh, what a huge play. Emmanuel with the putback. to give ASU the lead, 63-51 now. He just snuck underneath for that putback. And what do we got? Something underneath that might be on Tillis for a hold. And I believe that may be her fifth foul. And she is done for the day. Good game, though, for Ryan Tillis. She played well, particularly in the first half. No shooting. Just verifying that that is her fifth. Cody underneath. Take your time, A&M. Smith leaves it outside. Sanders, no good. Rebound knocked away from Ward. Actually, Emmanuel. And the rebounding foul will go against the Bulldogs. Virgin picks up the foul. That is her second.
Two shots.
And Emmanuel will shoot a couple here. 2:14 to go. Huge win if they can hold on here. It'll give them sole possession of second place.
Two shots.
Good on the first.
One shot.
She leads the team in scoring, averaging 17 a game. She only had two in the first half. You could say quarter, because she didn't play in the second quarter due to foul trouble.
Hornets convert both free throws.
She's come on strong here in the second half. 11 points in the second half. She's got 13 for the game. No fouls, ladies. 2 minutes, 5 to go. Taylor Smith trying to chase Sanders. Instead, Bergen will try the shot, no good. Underneath, the putback rolls in. Cody with a bucket. You give them up if they're underneath like that. You don't want a three-point play and the clock to stop. You've got the lead, now 12 points. A minute 39 to go. Crawford reverses, goes up with the left hand, missed the shot. Ward fighting for the rebound, can't get it. Here comes Simmons, racing down court. Shot good. I don't know how she rolled that one in, but it was a good one. And a timeout taken. I think Margaret Richards wanted the timeout, but instead, I think they awarded it to Alabama State. Whatever the case, it is a timeout. It's a 30-second timeout. And as promised, a couple of scores from SWAC action. We got a couple of finals. Southern has defeated Bethune-Cookman. The final there, 58-40. So Southern improves to 10-5. So they are right behind ASU, if ASU can hold on here. They would only be a game behind the Hornets. And then they'd be tied if ASU somehow finds a way to lose this one. Also a final, Grambling has knocked off Florida A&M, 64-46. Neither one of those teams, well actually, Grambling is in position to make the tournament. They are currently tied for eighth place with Alcorn State. Emmanuel almost lost it. Simmons, defender fell down, but that was not a foul. A minute to go. Emmanuel driving has it swiped away out of bounds. 11 on the shot clock.
Position Hornets.
Inside, nice pass. Shot is good, Crawford. Crawford in double figures. He has 12 points. I was going to check that Grambling score. I don't think I had a, yes, I'm sorry, not the Grambling, but the Alcorn State score. And they don't have anything posted for that game. I don't know why. Anyway, 52 seconds to go, a 12-point lead for the Hornets. Underneath, Bergen shot is good. At this point, you just got to make your free throws. You got a 10-point lead. Emmanuel in back court now slows it. I don't know why they're not fouling. They got to have about four more possessions at least. Emmanuel inside, left-hander good. Grace the other way, don't foul. Bounce pass, stolen. Ward with a steal, that'll do it. They can run out the clock. Manuel wants another bucket, why not? She missed the shot, rebound A&M, 2 seconds, one, and that'll do it. Very impressive win for the Lady Hornets. They win it by the final of 69. To 57. They improved to 12-4, sole possession of second place with two games left, and a huge one. This makes this one really big when they take on Southern on Thursday. It'll be down there in Louisiana. Winner of that game will have, or there will be a tie then at that point for second place. So very important games coming up for Alabama State. They win today, though, by the final of 69 to 57. Folks, we hope you've enjoyed it. This is our last women's home game of the season. We got the men's game coming up, so stay tuned for that. On the Hornets Sports Network.